Yeah. Hello, my name's Gummyroach. Thanks for joining me once again in my basement TV studio, where VHS technology is still alive, believe it or not. We are recording this particular video in VHS using old school analog video cameras and some VCRs. We'll be editing this later in post digitally so we can put it out there on YouTube for you all. But it's a walk down memory lane. It's kind of a pain in the butt to set all the old school stuff back up. But once in a while, it's like, yeah, why not dust off the old equipment and have a little fun with it and make a real crappy, grainy video compared to digital and just kind of suck it to you all. All right. Well, what are we going to talk about today? Today is a rainy afternoon. It's Saturday. I think it's March 29th. And I thought, what should I do? I'm bored. I think I'll make a video talking about some of the old stuff that I've got laying around the house. Today, the video is going to be about my very first computer system. This computer was given to me for Christmas back in, I think, 83, 84, somewhere around there. So fresh out of high school. But this computer was all the rage. Let me switch monitors here so I can show you all what it is. This is a Texas Instruments TI-99-4A computer. Now, this computer actually did come in a couple of different styles. There was a computer made by the same company, Texas Instruments, that was black in color with silver trim. And the same basic computer, I guess. I don't really know what the difference is between it and this one. But anyway, I've got on my desk, let me switch cameras here. I've got all kinds of stuff that I had in the box that came with this computer. So I thought I would hook this bad boy up and play around with it, just and maybe do a little video on this. So let me show you first of all the hookups on this thing. On the back, let me switch over here to my extreme close-up camera. Okay, on the back, we've got this little thing. It almost looks like a mouse port, a serial port, but it's not. This is a jack where you would connect a cable for a tape recorder. Tape recorder? Who uses those anymore? Well, I don't have the tape recorder anymore, but my brother, I think, has it. But I do have a small Walkman type tape recorder that if I really, really wanted to record data on a tape, I could still do it with that. I might eventually scrounge up another actual tape recorder, the standard one that it's intended to use. But that's what this jack here is for. You've got, I don't know where my hookup cord went, or I'd show you, but it breaks out, it plugs in here and it breaks out to play, record, and little mini pause. Not menopause, mini pause. little tiny mini jack that would plug into the pause port on your tape recorder. And instead of floppy disk, you would save and retrieve your data on a cassette tape. And you could, I guess, essentially add some pieces to this, some hardware to this to allow a floppy drive, but quite expensive back in the day. So continuing on, we've got our power connector, all right? And then over here on this side, we've got our audio and video output. Okay. Now, over here on the side, this looks like another serial port. This is for the joystick connector. The joystick would plug in over here. Okay. Now, the keyboard on here is very compact, as you can see. There are no function keys. It's just number keys, but they double as function keys. If you hold down, if you've got a control key over here, and you've got a function key here. So by holding down either this or that, and then pressing the numbers or some of the characters even, would give you different commands or functions or characters. All right. The on-off switch on here, I think this is what's a little bit different compared to the black and silver model, is the power switch is a little different. I think the black model has a power light, if I'm not mistaken. But anyway, a little slide on-off switch over here. Okay. Up here is where you would plug in cartridges, a little door here, and you plug in game cartridges. And not just games, you could get software cartridges too. You could do accounting, for example. Really cheesy graphics, I'll show you some of that. Games, software, whatever, you could plug in right here from a cartridge. On the side, this is, I think it's an RS-232 interface. And then you could plug from here into expansion modules and eventually get a printer and floppy drives going, if you really wanted to, if you had the additional pieces, which I do not. I do have this gadget here. This is a speech synthesizer. Okay. This thing here is an add-on, and certain games that you could get for this computer, this would enhance the experience supposedly, and allow the games to talk to you. Maybe additional music. It's still very, very cheesy compared to today's standards, but anyway, this would plug in to the side over here, right here. You just plug this bad boy right there. And then also, this had a little expansion port as well. So I guess the idea is that you could just keep on expanding and expanding and expanding. Pretty soon the thing would take up your entire desk instead of this big mess here. it just got this little door. If you're not using it, you can just close this. I have this little warning sticker here. It says, warning, keep door shut if you're not using. Now, something I haven't been able to figure out with the speech synthesizer is it has this little pop-up thing here. Now, I can't tell looking at this that this area does anything. Maybe it was the storage for some little add-on something or another. I don't know, but I don't think anything actually plugs into this top part. I could be wrong, but anyway, I just found it kind of interesting that opens and shuts. But anyhow, this would plug into the side of the computer. Let's go ahead and plug that in. And certain games, not all of them, but certain games, you could play with or without the synthesizer module. It just would add a few enhancements to the game, like sound effects and some voices, but still pretty lame compared to today's standards. But anyway, all right. Now, it came with originally, it came with these. Either I like this little box on my desk here. I can switch cameras so I can see what's going on the monitor, make sure that we're all set up here. But anyway, look at these. These are funny. I mean, they're not very comfortable to operate. Not very ergonomic, I guess, is the word. But anyway, it came with a pair. And these would, here's the cable. This would plug into the side of the computer. Little joystick port over here on the side. All right, but you could, if you wanted, and I did, you could get a better joystick, universal joystick, like this guy right here. This, you know, it's got little, it's easier on the hand. This would, you'd sit this on a table, I guess, and then you play it, and it's just a nicer joystick. But in order to, there goes my mic. In order to use this joystick, you would need this little adapter thingy right here. I guess the pinout for the joysticks was a little different for the enhanced joystick. So you could plug two joysticks in here. I've only got one of these newer joysticks. But anyway, plug those in there, and then the adapter would go over here on the side. Okay. And we will plug that in just a moment. Okay. Now, I talked about on the side here, on the back, it had this little port here. This is for audio video. Okay. Now, initially, when this was brand new, it had what's called a modulator device. This little cable here, this plugs into the back of the into the port on the back of the computer. But this has 1, 2, 3, 4. It has 5 connectors on here, 5 pins. One of them, I think, was low voltage power for the modulator, and then you had audio and video output coming through here. All right. Now, the modulator stopped working some time ago, and because I wanted to have the ability to hook this thing up to just a standard monitor instead of a channel 3 on your TV, and also be able to run it through a video recorder, I modified this. So I took from this jack, I'm such a genius, I took and wired separate video and audio cables out of it so that I can plug audio video straight into a monitor or into a VCR, and that's what we're gonna do. Okay, so let's plug this in. All right. Here we go. Okay, and I'm gonna plug this into the front of the VCR over here, my inputs. And I did mark them. Okay, audio right there, video, yeah, right there. Okay, and then we're gonna talk about the power supply for a minute. This power supply is so dang mooky. It's crazy. It's got the if you can see it, it's got the TI logo molded into the plastic, but a big bulky thing. Anyway, and then it's got a couple filters on the line. I'm not sure what they all do, but anyhow, here's the end of it. Let's plug this in. It goes over here. Okay. All right. Now, are we ready to power this bad boy up? See if it still works. Okay, here we go. I should set my inputs. Stop. Front. Okay, I've got everything hooked up. We're ready to power this bad boy on. So we're going to hit the switch. It's over here. You really can't see it, but slide that on. When you first turn the computer on, this is what you get. Now, a question. Does your Windows 10 machine boot up that fast? I didn't think so. All right. That's one thing about the TI-99/4A. It does boot up instantly. Bam, it's on, ready to rock and roll. Okay, when you first turn it on, you get these pretty little color bars. Oh, a rainbow. It just needs ruffles. Anyway, you get these color bars. Now, I don't know if these color bars are broadcast grade. They probably are not. But needless to say, I would use these color bars back in the day to help calibrate TV sets if I was tinkering around with them. You know, if those are broadcast grade bars, well, I'm in trouble because this monitor looks like crap in front of me. Anyway, so it's pretty self-explanatory. Press any key to begin. Let's do that. Okay, now, you've got a little game cartridge or software cartridge, I should say. It's not just for games. There is software, business software you can run on these. It's mostly for games, so that's what most people use these things for. But anyway, you've got a little slot here. And if you don't have anything in there, the only thing that comes up on the menu is basic. But if you did have something in here, you'd see some additional options on there. Press 2 for English, 3 for Spanish or whatever. Anyway, let's look at TI Basic for a minute. We're going to hit 1. And woohoo, TI Basic ready. Now this is very, very basic. Okay, basically it's basic, all right? It's very user-friendly. I spent many hours back as a kid tinkering around with this thing, just looking up programs in different computer magazines and just poking around on a keyboard and see what I could do. I don't remember a lot of the basic programming language. That was eons ago, years ago. But I do think that every line of text had to start with a number, so we'll start with 10. Well, maybe we'll start with 19. Typo. It's a small keyboard. We'll just say print. All right. And then 20. 29. I keep thinking that's a zero. We've just got go to 19. We can tell it to run. It's just going to go in a loop. Yep, runs right up the screen. See that? I don't know how you break out of it. I don't. Let's see here. Well, okay, fine. We'll just turn it off. I don't know how you how you stop the what do you call it? Okay. Anyway, moving right along. I just want to make sure I'm still recording. Yes, we are. Okay, so let's put some cartridges in here. I've got quite a few. Let's talk about the cartridges that came with this thing, first of all. I think there were two of them initially. We've got one called Car Wars. All right. You're not going to believe, well, you might believe, just how cheesy these graphics are. But take a look at this. Let's put this in here. Oh, you know what? I probably should have turned the machine off first before turning off and plugging in the cartridge. This thing's pretty robust. It doesn't seem to care, but I think I recall somebody saying that, yeah, you always want to turn off the machine when you take cartridges out or put them in. That's probably a good idea. Correct me if I'm wrong. Okay, so now we're going to hit a key, and now you can see that we've got something on the menu besides TI Basic. Let's press 2 for Car Wars. Here we go. Now, the idea here is to avoid running into the other car. Eat up all these dots, but you've got to be quick. And this joystick is doing some funny things. Ding! Okay. I haven't used this in years. But that's pretty much how it works. You got to eat up all these dots. And, it was fun for the day. I mean, you look at it now, and it's like, really? Seriously? Let's go back out. I can. Oh, come on. Out. Yeah, well, I don't know if this is completely working. But, nonetheless, kind of fun. I think you can set the levels on here also. As to, there you go. It might, the other joysticks might actually work better as well. Okay, so that's Car Wars. A little bit cheesy, but fun. Okay, the other one. I'm just dying to show you this one. This one came with the computer as well. It's called Hunt the Wumpus. And you're probably thinking, Hunt the what? The Wumpus. Okay. This is actually a pretty popular game. anyway, what the heck is a Wumpus? You'll see. Let's put this back in. Power back up. Make sure we're still recording. Yes, we are. Okay. Beautiful. Let's hit a key. And we're going to, you'll see it's in German and whatever. We're going to hit number 2. Hunt the Wumpus. That is a Wumpus. You like those wonderful high-end graphics? I thought you would. That's supposed to be a pit. Here's a close-up of the Wumpus. Okay, so we're going to go with an easy maze. All right, we're going to do normal. Isn't that cute? It's wrong. It's cute, though. All right, so the idea here, the object of the game is the Wumpus is going to be surrounded by two red dots in each direction, I think. And so as you go through this maze, you'll see either a green circle that in the case that you're getting close to a pit and you don't want to fall in the pit, or you may see a circle with a dot, or you might see a curve. All right. So far, we don't see anything, so we're safe so far. So you just move around the maze, okay. And also, this maze will screen wrap. So if I go to the right, I'm going to pop out on the left side of the screen. There we go. Okay, see that green up there in the corner? That means that there's a pit somewhere. The pit could be on, the pit's probably on the bottom part of the left, would be my guess. All right, there's a red dot, so we have to be careful there. But I can still move over to the left. Okay, there's another red dot. So I probably shouldn't move to the right any further. I can come down, though. Okay, so we know the Wumpus is not over here. But we know the Wumpus is somewhere in this area over here, below these red dots. Now, the idea is to surround the Wumpus and narrow in. Okay, there's a dot. Okay. And I forgot about the bat. If you land, if you go to the space with the bat, it can transport you to a random space on the board. And yeah, not good. Okay, here's our tally board. I don't know. Okay, here we go. So that's not good. I've got a red dot there. I'm gonna go up because you can see that I've got a clear space on the bottom. So if I go up, I'm going to end up there. So if I go to the right, okay, I'm just going to keep going. Okay, I used to be really good at this, but it was a long time ago. Okay. Kind of funny how it just kind of goes in a loop. You don't always know where the next spot is going to take you. Okay. All right. So, be very, very quiet. I'm hunting Wumpuses. Okay, let's go down. Ooh, that's risky. Okay, so we're over there. Let's go there. Ooh. So we're near a pit and we're near the Wumpus. Okay. Wumpus over there. Let's go down here. Okay. We're coming up to Wumpus territory. How about? Don't you love that? Just wraps around. There's another pit. Okay. Let me go to the right. Okay. So there. Okay. I'm thinking the Wumpus is. Let's go over here. Over here. All right. Go over here and down. Okay, I think the Wumpus is to my left, because if you really study this board, I think that's it. So I'm going to hit my white key, whatever it is, the gun, and then fire away. Let's see if we get it. I got it. I got the Wumpus. Nice. All right. So let's see. How do we... Okay, there we go. Another game. Are we bored with this one yet? Almost. Let's just play this a little bit more. Fill these in. Okay, there's nothing there. Nothing going on there. Okay, there's a pit. So, right there. Uh-oh. Okay, nothing there. Ooh. Okay. So we know these are fine. I'm thinking he's down lower, one space below where I'm at. Let's try that. Nope, he got me. Isn't that cute? All right, so let's see how we reveal the maze. To reveal the map, let's see here. Okay, that's where he was. Okay, but that's Hunt the Wumpus. Kind of fun, kind of a silly, stupid game, but, you know, back in the day, had some fun with it. And there's several different modes that you can play. You can play invisible mode, and you can add more curves to the maze and whatever. So it can be challenging at times. All right, so we're going to shut this off, and we're going to move on. Okay. Now, another game that came with this was, I don't remember. This is called Munch Man. This is a really cheap version of, kind of a watered-down version of Pac-Man. But let's give this a try. Okay. Recording still.
I think so, yep.
Okay. All right, so, turn on that Munch Man. Nice high-end graphics, don't you think? Okay. Press any key. There we go. This is, where am I? There I am. So this is, you know, like a cheap, like a Walmart version of Pac-Man, I guess. Really cheap. I guess you got Ghost on here too, but, where am I? There I am. Okay. Oh boy. Terrible. Of course, this monitor is like 5 feet away from me, so that doesn't help matters. It's just a 13-inch TV set. Are you ready? Yes. Okay. Boy, they got me. Game over. Well, just as well. That was stupid. Okay. That's Munch Man. Okay. Now, I mentioned that you could do learning on here. You know, there's TI Basic, but we also have some software, some educational cartridges that my brother, I think, managed to scrounge up at a thrift store. So this one here is called Music Maker. Oh boy. Let's turn this on. Let's see how cheesy this is. Okay, press the key, press number two. Here we go. Look at that. Boy. High-end audio, huh? Okay, what do we do here? Traditional mode. You can, okay. Time signature, 4:04. Speed, yeah, okay. But over here, you could actually create your own tunes if you really wanted to. I'm not sure why this joystick is not working. Maybe it just works with the TI joystick. But anyway, you can pretty much write your own music. It's kind of cheesy, but I don't know. If you're just starting out with music, yeah, maybe. Okay, next. It's another educational game is Alligator Mix. This one is pretty much a math tutorial. And I'm terrible at math, absolutely terrible at math. But let's try this. That. Number two for English. Okay. So the idea is to answer the question before the alligator gets you. All right, so right there, 2 plus 3, 5, 9, 3, 5, 1, It doesn't, you know, it doesn't really tell you what your score is until you're done, I guess. Seven minus five is two. Nine minus six. I'm terrible at math. Absolutely terrible. Anyway, it should come back. Let's see. Four plus seven is 11. But this will tell you what your score is at the end. So it's like a math tutorial, tutor. So yeah, makes learning fun, I guess. But you got to be quick, and you got to know where all your keys are on the keyboard too, or otherwise you're messed up. Anyway, so there's math. So moving right along. Okay, let's see here. We've got we've got personal record keeping. Right there. So anyway, we'll get the boring stuff out of the way first, then we'll get on to the fun stuff. Okay. Personal record keeping. All right. One moment, please. And this is one where you would want to look how old that is. Yeah, I don't know how you. Okay. So I don't even think you can erase the 19. That's how old this thing is. Printing device, no, we don't have a printer. To create a file, load a file, it's just very limited as to what you can do to store your info, but anyway, I guess it was useful back in the day. Okay. Now, some other games. Let's see here. We've got, let's try something that uses a speech synthesizer. This is called Princess and Frog. This is kind of a watered-down version of Frogger. But this one will use a speech synthesizer, so let's turn this guy on. And here we go. Oh, sometimes this game will give us grief when it tries to load. So let's turn this off again. Man, remember these cartridges are ancient. Let's try this again. All right. There we go. Okay.
Ready to start.
So the idea, you know, you're this little frog down there at the bottom of the screen. You got to get your way up to the top without getting run over. Yeah, or jousted. Try this again.
Ready to start.
Yeah. And to think I used to be able to play this pretty well. And you jump up here, jump on an alligator, jump on a worm, jump on an alligator, and go up there where the lips are. I missed it. All right, let's do this again. Here comes frog number two. Okay. And if you're supposed to mate with that frog. It's kind of the PG version of sex, I guess. And I missed the way. I keep running the wall.
Turn.
Anyway.
Ready to start.
Frog. It's kind of fun, but you'll notice the game does talk to you a little bit. But really limited, even with the speech synthesizer, you know, for its day, it was all the rage, but, you know, anymore today. Playing this, you're like, really? Okay, that's the end of that game. That's kind of fun. All right. Okay, and you'll notice that a lot of times these games that are made by third party have better graphics than the ones made by TI. Kind of funny. Some of them have better graphics than others. Here's a game I think is kind of interesting. I have no idea how you play it. It's called Microsurgeon. Let's take a look. Okay. Oh, there it goes. What are you supposed to do here? I have no idea. Press any key to begin. Well, I did that. Patient number zero. Student.
Patient is ready for microsurgery, doctor.
Well, I don't know what you're supposed to do here. I have no idea. I guess come up here and get rid of these little something. I don't know. No idea. But it's an interesting game. I guess you, the idea is to kill all these little things. But,
just a basic.
I don't know. No idea. My brother picked that game up. I don't know what he's thinking, but he's probably good at it. I don't know. Okay, so that's Microsurgeon.
Okay.
Oh, here's one called Amazing. Well, let's see how amazing it is, shall we? Okay. I had no idea I had all these game cartridges. It's crazy. Okay. Press key. That. Okay, now this game, you're basically a mouse trying to get the cheese, and you got to watch out for the cat. Let's see here. One player. I hit two players. All right. Escape maze. Okay. And we'll go with simple maze. Visible maze. Mouse holes, obstacles, fast mouse. I want a slow mouse. Cat section. How many cats? Let's go with two cats. All right. Do we want a dumb cat or a smart cat? Let's go with a dumb cat. Dumb cat. Standard cat or pouncing cat? We'll go standard. Okay. What are we supposed to do with this? Ah. Ding, ding. Where am I? Oh, there I am. A little tiny mark up there at the top. Slow mouse. Should have gone with something quicker. All right. This is dumb. Really stupid. And the cat's probably going to get me anyway, right? Okay. Yeah, that's stupid. What am I doing going down there? That's no exit. Okay. You know what? I'm bored already with this one. This is stupid. Okay. Next. Let's go with another one. Another game. Let's see. Hangman. Nah. Oh. GI Invaders. Here we go. This is very similar to... they did a pretty good job with this one. This is almost identical to the arcade. Very close. So, let's play GI Invaders. Merely aggressive or downright nasty? Let's go with merely aggressive for now. Okay. Here we go. Just like the real deal. Just like the arcade game. And I... died already. I'm so awful at video games. Yeah, one more time. Wouldn't you know it? TI Invaders, everyone. Okay, game over. Wow, that was terrible. Okay, next. Ooh. Here's one called Parsec. I remember this one. Let's try this one. Okay. Yeah, Press any key.
Press fire to begin.
I'm not sure what you're supposed to do with this. I think eventually.
Alert. Alien craft advancing.
Okay, yeah, you're supposed to. I don't have much control on this joystick. Boom.
Alert. Alien craft.
This used to be a fun game back in the day. Man.
Alert. Alien craft.
Terrible. This joystick won't go up. Okay.
Alert. Alien craft advancing.
Awful.
Alert.
Now you see why I don't play video games very often. I'm no gamer. Look at that. Terrible. Anyway, that is Parsec. Yeah. What else we got over here? We've got Blasto. Blasto. All right. Are we having a blast? I'm actually having fun with this. I am. I hope you are too, just watching this, watching me mess up. Fail. Okay. Tank trails. Go with none. Okay. I have no idea. I guess you're supposed to blast your way out of them. Is this kind of like Minecraft? Or what's that Microsoft game? Similar to that, I guess. Really cheap audio there. Come on. Move. I don't know what you're supposed to do with this. Blasto. So, game over. That's called Blasto. All right. Now, moving on. Those were most of those, except that Frogger game. Those were all TI Texas Instruments, and they're TI, I guess, is who put those games out. Now, did you know that Atari actually made some cartridges for the TI? They did. I've got several of those cartridges right now. This is Pac-Man, and this is pretty good, I guess. I'd say it's pretty close to the arcade game. I'll let you be the judge of that. There we go. And again, I used to play this all the time back when I was a kid. I don't play video games very much anymore, and I kind of suck at them. Plus, this joystick is really awful. It needs to be cleaned up, but you'll see that looks pretty similar to the real deal. Better than Munch Man. Way better than Munch Man. All right, here we go. go after this ghost. Ah. There we go. I'm after you. Maybe. Gulp. Ah. Whoops. Whoopsie. Okay. All these ghosts. This was a really fun game back in the day, though. I remember playing this at the arcade and just going through like 20 bucks worth of quarters. Probably even more than that. Playing Pac-Man. We had a field trip, German class had a field trip down to BYU. We, the friend and I could never find the rest of the class once we got there, so we spent the entire day in the arcade playing Pac-Man. We finally caught up with the class at the end. The teacher was none too happy, as you can imagine, that we spent the whole day in the arcade, but later on he thought it was funny later on. But, anyhow, yeah, that's all we did. We played air hockey and Pac-Man. Played air hockey till my arm was ready to fall off. Anyway, Pac-Man, let's hurry up and die already. There we go. Game over. Okay. So that's Pac-Man, and that's actually a pretty decent graphics. It's similar to the arcade, very close. So this was put out by Atari just for the Texas Instruments 99, those cartridges. I also have Donkey Kong, and this was another fun one that I really couldn't play very well, but we'll try it. Okay. Donkey Kong, 1983. Okay. Nintendo. Okay. Press enter. Beep. Okay. Run, 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 run. Run. Go up the ladder. There we go. Grab that. If I had a hammer, I'd hammer in the morning. I think in the arcade game, well, yeah, she does go help. The little girl up there yells, help. Oh, isn't that sweet? Okay. Ding. Oh, yeah, I remember this one. Bombs or whatever. You have to... jump up here. You know, if the bombs don't get you. This one, he doesn't want to go up that ladder. Come on. Move it. Yeah. Oh, well. He died. Okay, here we go. Let's go up this way. Yeah, I should know better than run into the gorilla. Okay. Beep. Game over? Yep. Okay. So that's Donkey Kong. Alrighty. I've got a lot more to show you. So, let's see. We got, oh yeah, Pole Position. Now, this is not anywhere close to arcade quality, but it was fun back in the day. So, let's see. Press any key. Let's see here. All right. Here we go. Boom. Change gears or not. But anyway, the idea is to stay on the road and not run into things. And finish the lap. But yeah, look how cheesy, how corny these graphics are. But this used to be all the rage back in the day. Okay, here comes the other cars. You gotta keep from hitting them and don't run off the road. Yeah. Yeah. But I had a lot of fun with this one. When I was a kid, this was on my Christmas wish list was to have this game. The pole position. There we go. Game over. Anyway, that was fun back in the day. To look at it now, all these years later, it's like, wow. Okay. That's pole position. Now, what do we got here? I showed you Donkey Kong. We've got I've got two copies of Donkey Kong, in case one of them broke. I don't know. Pole position, Donkey Kong. Ah, here's one. Centipede. And again, this is Atari cartridge, but made just for the TI. So let's try this one. Ding, ding. Centipede. My brother used to play this one a lot. Okay. Isn't that silly? Oh my. Noisy game. Gets me every time. This joystick really doesn't want to cooperate. Let's have to clean this guy up. It's been sitting, it's got a lot of dust in here. But that's Centipede. Okay. So. All right, I got two more games I want to show you. I thought I'd save the silly ones, the best ones for last, I guess. At least these are the best ones in my opinion. These were made by a company called Funware. All right, I don't know if this company is still around anymore, but these games were actually a lot of fun to play. This one here is called Ambulance. Now, this label, I need to put some more adhesive on here because this label's coming off. But anyway, this is called Ambulance. Let me just tell you a little bit about this game first of all before I start it up. Is Ambulance, typically you're supposed to yield to emergency vehicles, but in this game, as you will soon see, the vehicles do not yield to the ambulance at all. And so you've got to play dodgeball and keep these vehicles from running into you and keep from running into them while you pick up a patient. Also, it'll change colors depending on the how sick the patient is. You've got to get the patient to the hospital before the patient dies, so it'll start changing from white. It'll start blinking white, and then I think it blinks red, and then black is critical, near death or something. So you got to pick up the patients and take them to the hospital before they die. Well, the hospital is located on the other side of the railroad track. So sometimes when you're en route back to the hospital, you've got this stupid train you got to sit and wait for. So it's brilliant. It's ingenious the way they designed this. Let's give this a try. Okay, that. And let's see, number two, ambulance. Here we go. I like the little tune there. Isn't that cute? So the hospital is over there on the right side of the screen. Okay. And see where the railroad tracks are. We got a patient up there in the top. He's blinking red. Let's see if I can get over there and grab him. Uh-oh, black, critical. So I got to pull up to the curb. And then I got to watch out for traffic, get him down to the hospital. I'm going to get nailed. Nope. Bender. Okay, he's dead. Pull up to the curb, grab the patient. Okay, back to the hospital. Drop him off. Okay. We go over here. Grab the patient. See what I mean? Darn drivers. Where are we? Utah? All right. Let's see here. Back to the hospital. Just in time. Drop him off. Okay. Yeah, we're... Oh. Boom. But anyway, that's a really fun game. And I would play this for hours. And as you got better and the game progressed, the screen would change. It would get harder, and the hospital would be moved to a different area of town, and traffic would get even more severe, and the train would come more often. And it's chaos, but it's fun. Okay, I got one more game to show you, the best for last. Okay. This one here is probably one of my favorites. This is funware also. And the name of this game is called Hen House. Now, I don't know if they've resurrected this game and made it available for the PC or not. I wish they would, because this was actually pretty fun. It's chaotic. The graphics on here are really simple and cheap. But the game, the design of the game is brilliant. So what you've got to do is you're basically this farmer, and you've got a hen house. Hens are laying eggs, and the eggs are going to fall down these chutes. The chutes are going to be different sizes. On one side of the screen, you've got a truck that you take the eggs over to and unload. The other side of the screen, you've got a gun. Now, you can't unload the eggs in the truck and have the gun at the same time. It's one or the other. Also, you can't just put the gun down and pick it back up. You've got to put the gun away on the other side of the screen. I'll show you what I mean. So let's turn this back on. And you've got to watch out for poachers also. Okay, so press any key again. Here we go. Okay, we can shoot these crows as they go across the screen, rack up some points maybe, if I can get my gun to fire. Gun doesn't want to fire. Ha, ha, ha. Isn't that great? Oh, you know what? Because I don't have a gun. Let's go over here and get the gun. Oh, my gosh. Now I feel stupid. Okay. Now we're just shooting crows. All right. But it's funny because this game is deliberately designed to bring chaos. Now, this little character up there across the screen, that's a fox. And if a fox gets into the hen house, you know what that means. Game over. No ifs, ands, or buts about it. Now, you'll see that we've got the chutes are filling up. I've still got my gun. But if I go to grab those eggs, you can only grab the eggs when the chutes are full. All right. But if I grab the eggs, I have to put the gun away, which is over here on the left side of the screen. So right now, I'm just kind of... Now, see this guy up there at the top? That's a poacher. You got to shoot him. Okay. Now, he'll keep coming back. Uh-oh, I'm going to lose an egg. Ah, see that? And it ends up on my tally board. Put the eggs over there in truck. So you don't want to lose eggs. I think 6 eggs and you're gone. Game over. Okay, let's shoot this poacher. Okay. So I got my poacher, and it gets faster as the game progresses. All right. I can shoot more crows, I guess. You don't have to shoot the crows. That's just optional, but it gives you extra points. Okay, let's get rid of this poacher, dude. How'd I miss him? Okay. I told one friend when I was at school, she said, what do you like to do for fun? I just go, I play hen house. She's like, hen house? Is that anything like post office? No. No, it is not, as you can see. But it's fun. So this gets a little... you got to time your shot just right. This gets complicated because the game will set you up to fail. And you won't know... That was close. You won't know which you need to do first. Grab the eggs or shoot the poacher. But at all costs, you have to shoot the fox before the fox gets in the hen house, even if that means losing an egg or two. So the game's going to get faster as it progresses. There's really no way to win it. It's just a test of endurance, really. And just to see how crazy. It'll drive you bonkers after a while. Okay, we got a full shoot here. I better grab these. Right there. Dump them in the truck. There we go. Okay. All right, this one's about to fill up. But I have a feeling the poacher's going to show up any moment, probably. Now, is there a pattern to this game? There might be. I don't know. I'd like to think it's random, but you just never know. Okay, now let's grab this. Grab the eggs before they fill up. Yep. See, it's speeding up. There's my poacher. Grab the gun. Shoot him! Shoot him! Okay. Run back over here because that's going to fill up. Grab that. Take it all the way over there to the truck. This kind of reminds me of work in some ways, you know. It's so chaotic. Do you do this? Do you do that? What if you got two fires going on? Which fire do you put out first, you know? If you got buildings burning all over town, what do you do? Yeah, they can make another variation of this called Fireman, you know, where you got buildings burning, which fire you put out first. I could see that. Let's get this fox. Okay. All right, that's full. Run over here, dump the eggs in the truck. Okay. It's picking up. Going a little quicker. Okay, come on. Come on, farmer. Run. But you'll never know which one's going to fill up first, you know? Okay. Oh, no! See, I told you, it sets you up for failure. Here comes that damn poacher again. Come on, get that done. Come on, poacher. Get out of my hen house. Yeah, I think we got us a poacher in the hen house here. Get the gun. All right. This guy just does not give up. It's just keep coming back over and over and over. And the fox will come back. And yeah, here he comes again. This time I'm ready for him. Okay. Now, which one of these is going to fill up first? And you know, as soon as I put this gun away, the fox is going to show up. Or the poacher is going to show up. Oh, no. Okay. Let's grab this. Put that away. Run back over here, grab the next one. See, you can't grab multiple shoots either. It's only one at a time, which makes it ridiculous. Two eggs so far. Oh, weasel in the hen house. Weasel in the hen house. Get the fox. There we go. Now I gotta go over here. Oh, look at that. See, it's a chip for failure. This game does not want you to win, and you can't win it. Really, you just keep playing it until you've just gone bonkers, or until you lose too many eggs, whichever comes first. But it's fun. I wish they'd put this out for the PC if they haven't already. I've not seen it. I've only seen it on the TI. But it is a fun game. It was for its time. I spent many hours playing this. Alrighty. Here it goes. Get the gun, shoot him. the poacher will run faster, the fox will run faster, and oh no! Dang it! There we go. 3 eggs. Oh, there's that stupid poacher again. Oh no. Why do I still have the gun? Grab that. Dump it in the truck. I'm gonna shoot this stupid poacher. Farmer's work is never done. And if you just wait under the chutes, they never fill up, you know. But as soon as you're on the opposite end of the screen, that's when they that's when they fill up. Okay, let's see. It's going to speed up here any moment. It just gets wild. After a while, you're just running all over the place. You just don't know what to do. It's embarrassing when you go to shoot the guy and you miss him. Oh, I forgot about that one. Waka, waka, waka. You like these cheap sound effects? Waka, waka, waka. Ha! All right, there we go. Grab that. Take it over to the truck. Oh, poacher, poacher. There he goes again. Ah, I missed him. Okay. Isn't this silly? There he is again. Playing hen house. On a rainy day, why not, you know? Get out the old games and play them. Have some fun. Okay. Let's see here. Here he comes again. I imagine you can set the difficulty level on this game, too, I would think. Probably. Oh, see, now it's really booking. Ah! Grab that. I gotta grab this. Hopefully I can shoot the guy on the way back. But if I miss him, I'm screwed. Now I gotta go grab these other eggs. Ah! Reminds me of my job. They just keep increasing and increasing the call volume and never stops. Oh, man, I missed him. Now he's going to run off with one of my eggs. And I come out. Yep, see? They had to end sooner or later. And it did. Well, anyway, you know what? This has been a lot of fun. You know, it brings back memories of old times. And, you know, this machine, it needs a little cleaning up, but it still works. All right. I hope you enjoyed this. I really was looking forward to doing this video and had a few technical difficulties setting everything up, but we got it. We made it. Anyway, you know, I don't make money on my YouTube videos. I don't even know the first thing about how to go about doing that. And right now, honestly, I don't care. So, if you like this video and you want a thumbs up or like it, I don't care. I don't care one way or the other. I'm not here to beg and plead. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Click on like. No, I don't care. Don't do it. It's a trap. I'm not here to make money. So I'm just here to have fun. So I hope you enjoyed this. Enjoy the rest of your day. Thanks for watching. Maybe I'll see you in another video.